Prices of medianoche items and prime commodities will remain stable until New Year's Eve. That's according to the Philippine Trade Department. DTI Assistant Secretary Amanda Nograles says the price adjustment will happen next year when the agency starts releasing their approval of notices. 18 manufacturers have requested for an increase on some grocery items such as coffee and bread. Stephen Kua, president of the Philippine Amalgamated Supermarkets Association, agrees with the DTI, saying there will only be a price increase on medianoche goods if some of these items become sold out.
Whenever may pagtaas sa certain stores, no, for some stores, it's because nag-replenish sila. Naging conservative ang kanilang orders or hindi expected yung kanilang demand. No? So, naubusan, have to replenish. Sarado na yung kanilang regular distributor, no? Sarado na yung kanilang regular source of supply. So, they will have to look for other, no, suppliers like wholesalers or even other stores, no? So, mas tataas ang kuha nila, natural, mas tataas ang pasa nila.
Houthi rebels renew their call to U.S. forces to immediately leave the Red Sea. The Yemeni militant group issued a warning after the U.S. accused it of staging a drone attack on an Indian-flagged oil tanker in the waters. The Houthi denounced what it called as the militarization of the Red Sea by America and its allies. The group, allied with the Hamas, has targeted Israel-linked commercial ships in the area since the war in Gaza broke out in October. Persons deprived of liberty from the Makati City Jail were treated to some Christmas cheer through a Christmas festival inside the prison facility. Some prisoners and their families received gifts from jail officers. Regular visiting hours were also extended so that they can bond with their families for the whole day. There's also a Christmas wish list tree where PDLs can put their desired items for the holiday season.
Ngayon po, meron po tayong mga caroling para makita po ng mga pamilya nila at sila mismo mga PDL natin na hindi nila maramdaman yung mga kalungkutan, lalong-lalo na ngayong Kapaskuhan.
Philippine police record 6 cases of illegal firing of weapons ahead of the New Year revelry. The police spokesperson, Colonel Jean Fajardo, said Monday, 4 of the persons charged are cops and military personnel. Fajardo says the firearms of the involved policemen and troops have since been confiscated. But police are standing by the decision not to muzzle cops' firearms this year. One person is also confirmed to have been injured from a similar case in Pangasinan province. Authorities say efforts are underway to locate the suspect.
Yung isa naman po ay nangyari po sa San Manuel, Pangasinan. So hindi po nila nakita yung nagpaputok at nakita lang po nila yung mga pasyo po ng mga baril po na ginamit po na parehong caliber 45 po.
Regional drug enforcement operatives seized 13 million pesos worth of illegal drugs in Cebu City on Christmas Eve. According to Police Regional Office 7, the shabu was confiscated during a buy-bust operation in Barangay San Nicolas. The suspect, an 18-year-old male who placed the blocks of shabu inside Chinese tea bags, has already been arrested. Authorities are now tracing the source of his drugs. Meanwhile, another man was arrested in a checkpoint in Barangay Basakpardo, Cebu City, for transporting illegal drugs. The man will face charges of violations of the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act.